Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Curvature tool in Adobe Illustrator. And while we're at it, I'll be answering the question, which one should you use, the pen tool or the Curvature tool? So let's move to another document, and in this video, I'm not going to be showing you how to use the pen tool because I have a tutorial that I'll link to at the end of this video, and it goes into depth about how to use that tool. However, there are a lot of similarities between the pen tool and the curvature tool. And we find the curvature tool on the left toolbar, and it's right next to the pen tool. It looks almost the same as the pen tool, except for there's this little curvy line off the end of the point. The keyboard shortcut is shift accent, not to be confused with shift apostrophe. The accent key is located left of the number 1 on your keyboard. So I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut shift accent, and now my cursor changes to the curvature tool. You'll notice there's a little asterisk next to the curvature tool, and that just means I don't have the curvature tool attached to anything yet. But once I click down with my mouse, and I'm going to come over here and click on this anchor point, and now the asterisk is gone. Now what we can do with the curvature tool is we can make straight lines or we can make curved lines. Let's go to the left and I'll show you how you make curved lines. Now I'm going to imagine where the anchor points might be on this circle, and I'm going to get as close to one as I can, but I'm only going to be concerned about being on the path. If you don't see the word path, you need to go up to View and then down to Smart Guides and turn that on. The keyboard shortcut for that is Command U. So I'll click down once with my mouse, and then I'll come to where I think the next anchor would be, and I've actually hit it right here. So I'll click down with my mouse, and notice what's happening. This first line has fallen right into place. This second one hasn't yet, but let me come up and guess where the next anchor would be and click down and see how Illustrator has now rounded out the path. And then I'll come over to this anchor, and if I click once, then the next move that I make is going to be curved as well, and I don't want a curve. I want this to be a point, so I'll double click on it, and then I'm able to actually make a straight line. So I'll come over to anchor, double click, anchor, double click, and that brings me back to my starting anchor. And notice now I have a little round circle next to my curvature tool, which is just telling me that I'm about to join my path with the beginning anchor. So I'm going to click one time here, and when I just click one time, it curves that line. But if I double click, Illustrator is going to turn this into a corner. So in a nutshell, that's how the curvature tool works. As you're moving along a curved surface, especially if it's a complete circle, Illustrator is going to do a really good job of guesstimating where the stroke needs to go. But when we have a more complex design, it's a little more difficult. With this next example, I'll first trace it with the curvature tool, then I'm going to show you how it works to start with the pen tool and just use the curvature tool to adjust the curves. I'll get the curvature tool first, shift, accent. So I'll start at the anchor, come down about halfway, click on the path, then come to the next corner, double click, come down halfway, click on the path, come back to the next corner, double click on anchor, double click on anchor. Now this curve is not a perfect circle, so I already know I'm going to have to come back and fix that when I'm finished, but let's come down to the corner anchor here, double click, go to the path, go to the path, path, this is a corner, double click on that corner, stay on the path, click on the path, double click on that corner, double click on the next corner, double click on the anchor, double click on the anchor. And when I come to the end, you see I have that little circle again. I'm about to close this path, so I'll click one time, and when I click once, the line is curved, but if I double click it, I'm going to add that corner. Now I've got to fix a couple of spots, so I'm going to come to this line here, and with the curvature tool, just grab where I think it needs to move and drag it into place. As I click, I'm adding an anchor. You can see the anchor that's added, so try to be strategic, but you can move the anchor until you release your mouse. And this was a little curved here. We'll add that there. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard and deselect that. And that looks pretty good. I'm going to delete this and show you what happens if I start with the pen tool. The keyboard shortcut for the pen is P. Now with the pen tool, you're not going to have to double click to make a corner. You're just going to press down one time for each anchor that you place. So I'm going to start with this spot here, click down once for these anchors, and then I'm going to guess on the circle here. Come back and hit this anchor, guess on the circle, find that anchor, and another anchor. This does seem to go a little faster to me. Maybe it's because I'm used to using the pen tool, but I'm able to maneuver this pretty quickly. Guess here, 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 and here, and then we close that out. Now, with the anchors placed, I'll get the curvature tool, keyboard shortcut, shift, accent, and I'll begin adding curves in between my anchors. I had to do this on some of the pieces anyway, so it isn't taking a whole lot longer, but I feel like I have a more accurate representation of this tracing by using the pen tool and then the curvature tool. And then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to deselect it. And that looks pretty good as well. So to answer the question, which one should you use, the pen tool or the curvature tool? Well, I find myself using both. I don't use the pen tool in the same way I used to, but it's good to know how to use it. So check out that tutorial. What I don't like about using just the pen tool is when I have curved lines, I have to play with the handles to make sure that I get that curve just right. But overall, the pen tool is faster for me. So what I do most of the time is start with the pen tool and get the basic anchors placed, and then come back in very quickly with the curvature tool and add my curves. I suggest you practice and become comfortable using both the pen tool and the curvature tool, because there are applications where they both are going to be the best answer. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.